847 at WPLJ. We mentioned this earlier. We have the students here from Huntington Central Regional High School in Flemington, New Jersey. Let's hear it for yourself. Yeah. Yeah. And this morning, they're going to do their version of Scott and Todd's Crime Buster Theater. This morning, the title of our mystery is The Radioland Murder.
Ooh.
And taking the part of Scott and Todd, Naomi, and all the other characters will be students from the high school communications class today. Mrs. Lynch's class. Now, Cato, who you got playing who?
Jess Falls will be the narrator.
That was my part.
Right. Marissa Sabatino will be Anne, the receptionist.
Okay.
Gabe Perry will play Sergeant Michael Scott Shannon.
Who's playing? Oh, man. Who's playing me?
That's Gabe.
Gabe. Over there.
Oh, boy.
Say hello, Gabe.
All right, Gabe.
And Dave Kaznicki will be Rob Brandt, radio host.
Go, Dave!
That's your live wire, right?
Yeah, there. He's fired up.
Dave is the live wire.
He's ready. He's ready for the Ricky Show.
That's right.
You kicked him to the curb, homeboy.
All right, G. I'm telling you, he's ready to go.
All right.
Now you got Gabe, right?
Right.
And Dave over there. I can't see the man on the other side of the console.
Right.
No one pay attention. See if you can get this one for a change.
I'm with you, Scott.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Scott and Todd's Crime Buster Theater. Today's episode,
The Radioland Murder.
It was a normal day at a radio station, WACB. The afternoon talk show host, Lush Bimbaugh, had just finished the first hour of his 12 o'clock show. After returning from the restroom during the commercial break, he started his theme music.
Wait a minute. We got no theme music.
Oh, no.
Welcome to the Lush Bimbaugh Show.
Sat back in his cushion, custom-designed broadcast chair and leaned forward to grab the microphone. Suddenly, 50,000 volts of electricity surged through his body. And Lush fell to the floor, a smoldering ember of a talk show host he once was.
Oh, no.
Luckily, Sergeant Michael Scott Shannon worked right next door, so he arrived at the scene within moments.
All right, who's holding out on me?
Not me. Sure, that Lush was a fake, a phony, and a fraud. But I didn't kill him. I'm Rob Brandt, another one of the hosts here at WACB.
You're who?
And I'm no killer.
Who are you?
Rob Brandt.
Rob Brandt. All right, relax. I'm not accusing you of anything.
All right.
All right. I mean, who's holding out with the food? I smell kielbasa.
And Shannon, you smell Lush Bimbaugh's body. He was fried to a crisp.
I see, and who are you?
My name's Ann. Ann Certiphone.
Ann Certiphone?
Yeah, I'm the receptionist. I was answering phones when this horrible accident occurred.
This was no accident, ma'am. See that wire running from that microphone? It leads to that electrical outlet. And there's another one running from Lush's chair. All he had to do is touch the microphone and zap! The circuit was complete.
It's sick out there, and getting sicker.
But he had been on the air for an hour before it happened.
I guess he didn't touch the mic right away. Do you know of any psychopathic listeners who might have wanted Lush dead?
Yeah, that a Damien kid. He probably did it.
Who's that?
His first name's Mac. Macadamian?
He's a real nut.
He used to call Lush and threaten him all the time.
Let me see his Lush's phone messages, Miss Certiphone.
Sure. Here they are, Sergeant.
Let's see here. Mrs. Bimbaugh called at 9:30. I'll be listening today, darling. Macadamian called at 10:07. Please call. He called again at 10:23. Why don't you return my calls? Again at 11:02. I'm going to get you, sucker! Simon and Schuster called at 11:32. Your royalty check's in the mail. Macadamian called again at 11:45. And Jimmy Deal called at 11:52. Just following up on that resume I sent you. That's it.
Sounds like that Macadamian guy's a real sick freak. Are you going to arrest him, Sergeant?
I can't arrest anybody yet, but I do have a suspect.
Who did Sergeant Shannon suspect, and why?
The Radioland Murders, as performed by the students of the Huntington.
Good job. Oh, man. I thought my favorite line in the whole thing.
They're sick and getting sicker.
Yeah, Macadamian, he's a real nut. 1-800-321-WQPLJ. I was going to say kill W, kill Boss.
All right.
If you know who killed Lush Bimbaugh, right there in his EIB chair. We'll give you tickets to the PLJ Listener Appreciation Concert. Hey, once again, a round of applause to the kids this morning.
Good job, Brad.
Hunterton Central Regional High School Communications Class, 852 NYPD Blue last night. Jim.
95.5 PLJ, Scott and Todd in the morning at 9:22. New York City weather. No, you know what? Let's wait a second. Let's get one of the kids from the Hunterton Central Regional High School. Come on over here. What's your name?
Eric.
Eric, I want you to do the New York City weather for everybody. You're a professional radio DJ. You ready? Say New York City weather and go ahead.
New York City weather. Mostly cloudy and mild today with a high of 65. Clear and cold tonight with a low of 37. Thursday, sunny and cool with a high of 55. And for Friday, sunshine, blue skies, a high of 60.
Right now it's 49.
Oh. Right now in Midtown Manhattan, it's 49 degrees.
Good job.
Wow.
Hey, come here, young man. Your name, Eric?
Yes.
Eric, you got good timbre to your voice.
Doesn't he?
Timbre. It means you got a good tone. You got good tonal qualities.
Oh, thank you.
You got a lot of people when they're young, whether it's kids or not, when they first, somebody throws them on the radio, their voice leaps up into to a high zone.
Right. Mm-hmm. You have to train it, see, to stay with
certain parts of your body shrink up and your voice goes way up high.
We got a lot of nice voices in here.
My man's got some cool Kenny G hair working, too.
Thanks, Todd.
No problem, man. Probably could have skipped that, couldn't he, Eric?
Yeah. Probably.
No, yeah. I like it. Probably it's a compliment. Skip that right
Wasn't
off.
It a compliment?
Kenny G's sure. Cool.
We love it.
Yeah.
Kenny G's nose.
Kenny G's
cool.
He is.
Okay. Kenny's happening, man.
Oh.
Had some notes here. Our names are Vinny and Lisa Esposito. We own Esposito. Where'd the guy go? He was on the phone a minute ago.
I don't know.
Oh, no. Not again.
Could be him calling back.
Hello, PLJ.
I wish to commend the Hunterton Central High School radio, WCVH. They were great this morning.
How about that?
And I'm an alumni, the class of 69.
Really?
Wow. Yep.
They also are getting ready to win their second field hockey tournament, right? When's that,
they
Saturday?
They sure are. This Saturday, and they're going to do it.
It's Sunday, man.
Oh, Sunday.
What are they playing?
Randolph.
That's his mom.
Randolph?
And where's that rebel Schneider in the house? You scam him.
Has he got the big Aggie hat on?
He's the Aggie. He's the scammer of the whole group. The rebel.
All right. And what a nice, quiet mom he's got.
I'm an alum, y'all.
I'm not his mom.
Oh, you're not?
No.
Yes, she is. She denies all knowledge.
You were real nice to all of them. We thank you.
Thank you.
Great.
You
and
should
I
be
know
proud.
Who killed Rush Lumberger.
All right, goodbye, lady. See you later. We're sending you home, your son home in one piece.
Here. Joey, that guy that sent that nasty fax.
Okay.
Did he call in? We put him on hold for you.
No, I'll check right.
Good morning, America. 17 minutes after 8 o'clock. Scott and Todd got a brand new phone scam at 9:30 this morning. Free tickets to the PLJ Long Island Listener Appreciation Concert. More wrestling tickets. We'll check out the Scott and Todd Listener Mailbag. And our special guest this morning, all the way from Flemington, New Jersey, Miss Joanne Lynch's class from Hunterton Central Regional High School.
Yeah. Apparently she gives a lot of notes. I was talking to some of the guys out in the hallway. So I can't believe them. I come out of that class, my hand is ready to drop off.
They're communication students. They have their own little radio station called WCVH, correct?
Yeah.
And that stands for the Community Voice of Hunterton County.
I like it.
Yeah, they were watching me do the news. They told me they've done their own newscast. They have their own digital carts and the whole thing.
And they have radio names.
Yeah.
Oh, they changed their names?
Yeah. Where's is there a Sylvester and Tweety show?
Yeah, he's in there.
Where's Sylvester at?
Come on in here,
hey, Sylvester. Come here.
Sylvester and Tweety.
Bring him in here.
They're in the hallway.
What time? Now, when you have a college or high school station, you don't get to have like a regular show every day like we do. You get one day a week. 1 hour a week. You,
2 hours.
Yeah,
you don't
shake. You don't shake your heads on the radio there, do you? You go ahead and talk like we do, right?
Right here, Joe. Put Sylvester and Tweety
Where's
right
Sylvester?
Here.
Where's Tweety at? There's Tweety. What's Tweety's name?
Hi.
What's your name?
What is it?
Melissa,
come on. In that microphone now. Really, everybody needs to hear your name.
Now turn your earphones off for this. And your name, you're Sylvester?
Yeah.
Sylvester, what's your real name?
Justin Formanet.
Justin.
Yeah.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Do you know him?
Yes, I do. Hey, Fudd, it's Mom. Did you bring your lunch money?
hey, Sylvester.
Payback, son, payback.
What's the deal on this little Sylvester guy?
What's the deal? That he's a nice-looking kid?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And he's a great, inspiring DJ, I guess.
Oh, he's going to be a DJ.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, and he's got a nut for a mother.
Yeah.
Say thanks, Mom.
Yeah. Oh, Justin, I've been wanting I can embarrass you state by state, and I'm bigger, baby.
You've done a pretty good job humiliating him so far today.
Yeah. He's speechless.
I hope this is not the representative of what happens on the Sylvester and Tweety show.
No, what do you guys, how do you open your show?
Yeah, what do you do?
We start with the Happy Happy Joy Joy song.
Right.
All right, hold on.
I can get you that.
We got
that.
Yeah,
we have that. We play that a lot.
We got the whole thing right here for you. Happy Happy Joy Joy. I think it's behind you, Todd. Hold on, Sylvester. Hold on, Tweety. We'll fix your right up.
Is it an involved opening after you play that? Then you do this
skit? Then what do you do?
No.
No.
I can't find it. Who's got Happy Happy Joy? Maybe they took it. Anyway, what do you do after Happy Happy Joy Joy?
We just play a regular song, like Hole or Nirvana or something.
You played like Hole?
Yeah.
And then maybe a little Pearl Hole. Jam?
Yeah.
Oh, where's Joey B? Oh, you kids today and your rock and roll music.
Why'd you pick the names now? What's significant about that? Why you call your show that?
He thought of it. I don't know.
I don't know. I just
picked your kid thought of it, Sue.
Yes, I know.
Are you guys?
It was his idol when he was like 3 years old, Sylvester.
Are you guys an item, or are you just team up for the radio
show?
Yeah,
you're better off like that. You get to be fooling around like that. You don't want that.
Oh, you know,
you don't
want to
be
good.
Dating.
Look what happened to Stevens and Gridman.
Yeah,
that's a radio comedy team. Married, they fought all the time.
All the time.
They fight like two old married couples.
Really?
You would think, yeah. When they're on air, I've seen them off air, and they're arguing back and forth.
I about had enough of the mother.
Goodbye, Mom.
Bye.
See you. You're gone.
Now, she should be on the radio.
Let's figure this out. You guys know about this Ricky Lake deal, don't you?
Yeah.
What do you think about that? What do you think about that? Is it big media manipulation or what?
I don't know. I wouldn't put it past her, but she might actually have a true cause, so I don't want to say anything that would hurt her as a person, you know? She might have a real cause.
How about Sylvester and Tweety? What do you think about Ricky Lake?
What happened?
Okay.
All right, good.
You see you right on top of it there. Ricky Lake gets out of jail after taking part in that anti-fur protest demonstration. She said, I didn't do it for ratings.
No.
That's the farthest thing from my mind.
Never occurred to her.
I didn't want the free publicity.
You know what kills me? When she was talking to Dave, though, she's like, it was...
Hey, PLJ.
Hey, how you doing? I'm just calling to... wanted to pick up that question that Letterman put to Ricky Lake last night. What if another group had come to her show and did what she did over there at those offices, what she thought of that? And well, she was kind of evasive, and she sort of skipped right over the subject. She never really said if it would be all right or, you know, how she'd feel about it.
Really?
Interesting.
And, yeah, I just thought it was really... He turned off and like into a journalist all of a sudden, and she just avoided the whole deal.
Now, we got one of the students here from the 100 in Central Regional High School. What's your name?
Eve Shapiro.
All right, Eve, what were you saying about Ricky Lake?
She wears leather shoes every day, different designer pair.
Really?
Wonder where they get that leather.
Huh. I think there's animals that comes from, isn't there?
I believe that leather comes from animals.
Yeah.
No, oh, that's a different story.
Of course, that's my shoes. What do you want me to do, wear bare feet on my
show? Remember when we learned that Ricky Lake was thrown in jail because she felt so bad about the animals? Well, we now have learned that Ricky pulled a scam, a major sham, to shine some light on her career. It's Ricky Gate. They came and took Ricky away, ha ha. They came and took Ricky away, ho ho, hee hee, ha ha. To a prison cell where Ricky's scam paid off, she thought. Now we'll be happy to see her ratings fall behind Richard Bay. Please come and take Ricky away, ho ho. Come and take Ricky away.
Scott and Todd.
TLJ. One big scam.